I couldn't resist doing a video on the brand new app from Adobe, which is Illustrator. Yeah, that's right, Adobe Illustrator for the iPad. So I have been waiting for this app to launch for a long time, and I'm so happy that I finally have it. I've been resisting the urge to open it, and I thought I'd film a little first impressions video with you guys so you can see what it's all about. Now, I obviously have the Adobe subscription and it's free within my existing subscription, but if you don't have an Adobe subscription, you can try it free for 30 days. So if you're watching this and want to give it a go, you can, but yeah, let's just get straight into the video. So I'm gonna click on my Adobe app, and this is what we see on the home screen. So on the left, I've got home, a folder for my work. Oh, cloud documents is gonna be so handy. It means I can like work on things between my laptop and my iPad and like collaboratively use them, which I think is great. We've got learn with some tutorials, and then discover, which is more tutorials. And then at the bottom, we've got create new and import and open. So like I said, I can work on something on my laptop and then bring it into here. But for now, I'm just gonna open up a random size. Let's just go with poster. And now it's brought up an artboard on my screen. So we've got a little thing here. What's this? Not sure what that does. We'll figure that one out. Can we pinch to zoom? Yes, so we can pinch it. We can't rotate it, but we can zoom it in, and then I'm presuming we can create new artboards because we've got an artboard tool here. Yes, so if I wanted to like create something else as well, like an A4, it'll add another artboard next to it, and then I've got two artboards on my screen. Hopefully you can see that because my screen is on the white setting, but yeah, very happy with that. Oh my God, I've just automatically pressed the undo button. So on Procreate, I'm sure you guys know Procreate, if you press two fingers on the screen, it will undo, and that's just happened. So that's amazing. And then redo on Procreate, I'm sure is three fingers. Yes, so redo is three finger tap, undo is two finger. We have the selection tool, standard. We've got, I'm presuming this is the direct selection tool because it's got like an anchor point picture on it. Then we have the pen tool, which I'm very excited to try. The idea of drawing vectors on my iPad that can seamlessly be like transferred back onto my laptop just is gonna change the game when I'm like designing things. If you haven't already subscribed to my channel, by the way, please don't forget to hit that subscribe button and join my creative family. I do videos about graphic design, about being a creative, an entrepreneur. So if you would like to follow along with my videos and watch more fun content, I upload every Thursday, and I'd love to have you as a part of my little family. And I'm actually very close to 100,000 subscribers, which blows my mind. Back to the video. So pen tool, let's see how this works. So I'm just gonna click, it's made an anchor point. Then if I click and drag, yeah, it's bringing up the handles like it would on my laptop. Click once and it creates just a blunt anchor point. I wonder if it does that thing where you can like draw the handles like this, and then if I want to get rid of this handle, click the anchor point. Yes, and it's got rid of that. And then I can start at a right angle again. Yep, enjoying that. And then you just join it all back together. No idea what that shape is, but we'll roll with it. Then I guess the fill and stroke is here. So it's currently on black. So let's change that. Ah, the color. Ooh, okay. So it has my color libraries and everything in here because it's connected to Creative Cloud. So it has my Happy Home library, which is from my Adobe Illustrator course. If you haven't yet signed up to that course, by the way, I've had such great feedback from it. I will leave that linked in the description if you want to learn more about Adobe Illustrator. So yeah, let's just put it in a random color for now. So that's that. We've made the pen tool. Can we adjust things? Okay, so we can adjust the anchor points with the pen tool selected. And then I'm guessing up here, we can adjust the anchor points with the direct selection tool. So we can change the handles. It's literally behaving how I'd expect it to. Ooh, there's a Bezier point, so we can curve the corners. So if we had a square, we can make it like a rounded rectangle. And then there's actually loads of options down here. So we've got, I'm guessing that's cut. That is like round a corner. So let's say we wanted this corner in particular to be rounded. If I click that, yeah, it's added the handles on, and then I can change the handles What's this one? Delete anchor point or delete handles maybe? Ah, that's deleted the handle. That's deleted the anchor point. Then the delete button, I'm guessing that's like join, simplify. Oh my God, it's even got simplify. That's cool. Okay, we'll have a play around with that in a little bit. Let's delete that layer quickly. Up here on the right is the layers panel, which is exactly where I'd hope it would be. Then the pencil tool, I mean, the pencil tool is pretty self-explanatory. It draws just like a straight line with anchor points. At the minute it is on orange with no strokes. If I flip it round, it'll be just the line. I'm very impressed so far. Yes, we've got the blob brush. I love this brush. I feel like this brush is just so intuitive. I love like doing first sketches with this, and we have different versions of it. So, let's just change the size. Change the size, smoothness. What color do we want it on? Orange again. You can change the brush settings, and then I can draw shapes. So let's go with an orange snowman. Who else is excited for Christmas? I'm looking forward to just some festive cheer, you know, even if it's not in the same capacity as normal, just a bit of festive cheer. And I love fairy lights, so, you know. But yeah, I've drawn myself a snowman with a blob brush tool. And now if I go back to my direct selection tool and click it, you can see that it's created the anchor points on the outside. I can simplify them. I love that. And then I wonder if there's some settings up here. I can like change the fill, the blend mode. So this is literally the properties panel, like it is on the desktop version. That's really cool. What else do we have? The eraser. I'm guessing that's just as always. Yeah, the eraser, and then change the size of it down here. Let's get rid of my snowman. And I'm gonna draw, let's draw a house. So with the square, I want it on fill. I'm gonna draw a square. One thing that I do use quite a lot is the like constrain thing. Generally like shift constrain, and it makes it like a solid square. Like how do you do that on this? Do you like press the screen, or maybe press the screen as you're drawing? No, that didn't work. Let's go up into the options menu. Okay, touch and hold the circle while you use different tools or actions to change their behaviors. Oh, so that's what that little circle's for. So it's like a right click button effectively, or like holding shift. Create a shape, I can constrain it with that little button. Okay, so I want to draw a square. So let's draw a dodgy rectangle and click this, and it's constrained it. That's what I wanted. That's all I needed in my life. Then let's add a triangle, change the color, draw that in, review, and it does have the grids. It's literally snapping, so it's got smart guides on. I love smart guides. I always have mine turned on. Happy with the shapes. There's a rotate as always. I can bezier the corners. I can lock it. I can change the order of the layers. So if I click this one and do a drag on my screen, it decides what's in front and what's behind. This is super intuitive so far. I'm very impressed. Let's go to text. So I'm guessing I just click and it'll do point type. Yes, of course, wouldn't expect any less. So it's just used filler text. The properties bar came up automatically. One thing I saw on the Adobe Max like announcement was that it is integrated in with like Adobe fonts, so it has something like 18,000 fonts available to you. So if you just click more fonts, you can go across depending on the different like tags, pick the style you want and click on that, and it'll change it. And I just think that's so good. And then you can also add your own fonts into it if you have your own like downloaded ones. Then we've got the regular like font options. You can change the fill and stroke, blend mode, opacity. Amazing. Can we resize it with these? Yes, we can. So we can resize it with the handles. We can rotate it. We've also got some options down here. I love that it has the options both here and here. Like, it just allows you to have more freedom, I guess. There's like size, letter spacing, line spacing, the order, the arrangement, I guess, the move, lock, duplicate, delete. I'm just amazed so far. So we've done the artboard tool, so that's got loads of different presets, or you can make your own, I'm presuming. Oh yeah, you can make your own artboard here. Oh no, actually this changes the current artboard. So I can like drag the height and width of my actual artboard. Nice. Then this import, so I can import from camera, photos, files, cloud documents or libraries, then obviously like the colours. Okay, so what's up here? So we've got the layers panel. It's creating layers as I'd expect it to. It's got a lock button, a view button, you can add layers, then obviously the properties panel. So when you click on an object, its properties are there. Love it. And then what's this? Precision. Ah, so this is the grid. So the smart guides is turned on. So you know when I'm like moving things and those pink lines are coming up, that's smart guides. You can snap to grid, have a grid on, change the grid. Guides on, nice. Then what's this one? Combine shapes. Oh, so this is Pathfinder and Shape Builder. So if I highlight both of these shapes, this is literally like coming to me straight away. Like if you are familiar with Illustrator already, you'll be loving this, because I am. So the shape builder, you literally like scribble across the shapes you want to keep and it'll join them together. Or I remember them saying this in the Adobe Max thing, if you tap, it will delete the shape. So if I were to create like a cloud and you combine them all, let me just zoom in. But if you click once, it deletes it, so anything in front it will get rid of. Oh, I'm loving this so much. Let's go back to my combine shapes option. So combine all, minus front gets rid of the shape that's in front, intersect joins them together, I'm guessing, and then exclude, what's this one, edit. Oh, so we've got cut, copy and paste, copy appearance, paste appearance. So I'm guessing that's when it like copies the color and the gradients and stuff. Align, yes, so glad this is here. So if I wanted the roof of the house and the building of the house aligned, I can highlight them both, go to the align tool, click align in center, and it will like jump them together, so like perfectly aligned. And then there's also the flip tool, so it can flip it like that way round, vertically or horizontally, so it would like flip it upside down. One thing I've noticed it doesn't have so far is the type on a path tool, because we got the point type tool. Is there a text box? Yeah, so you can get a text box too. So if you click, hold and drag, you get area type. Maybe when we click on this, we can outline the text, so we can convert the text to a vector, and then we've got type on a path. Okay, so how do we do this? Let's get it to draw like type up here. So let's change the font to just something basic, change the size. How do we get it to type on a path? Because that is not selected at the moment. Maybe if we put it on top? No. What happens if we highlight, I get the right tool selected. Highlight them both, then, yeah, that's it. Highlight them both, type on a path, and it'll type around the outside. So you can like move, wait, can you move the handles? Yes, you can move these around just like you would normally. So if you want to like type around a circle, which is really common for logos, I do that quite a lot, that's the one to use. I'm buzzing about this. I'm so excited. Let me know if you want me to create like a full-on drawing with Illustrator and record it for you guys. Maybe I could make a logo or like a scene illustration or like a portrait, a vector portrait. Let me know in the comments. I'd love to get creating with this. What's this one? Ah, so this is like compound paths, groups. So let's just select these both. So we can expand appearance, group, which obviously like joins them together. So you select them both at the same time. Clipping masks, I'm not gonna go into this. If you wanna learn more about Illustrator, there's so many tutorials online, or of course my Adobe Illustrator course. That shameless plug's gonna keep slipping in there because I'm very proud of myself. And then we've got create stroke outline, nice. Convert to guide, so you can turn any shape into a guide that won't like affect your actual artwork. It just kind of like hovers in the background. Then make compound path, love it. Amazing. So we can edit the path too. What's down here? Oh, so this is the same path options as before. So if I click this like that, yeah. So I've got the direct selection tool selected and I've got these options. So I can cut, convert to corner, convert to curve, join path, simplify path. I'm loving that that's there. Smart delete and delete. I feel like they've given you everything you need to begin with. The only thing that I haven't found yet is an eyedropper tool. Maybe this is like Procreate, because in Procreate you like click and hold on the screen, an eyedropper thing pops up and then you can choose a colour. Maybe I'll look in the tools in a second. Then we've got repeat, so you can radial repeat, grid repeat or mirror. Ah, I remember this from the tutorial. So let's take the square, put it in radial and it like repeats it around, and it's brought it up in the properties. So if you change it, it only repeats it twice, 22 times, and you can kind of see that it's like copying them all around. I suppose you could have some quite fun effects with that. Let's just undo that. Then grid, nice. So it's literally like as if it's starting a pattern, and you can change the options for the grid, how many spaces in between. Love that. That's a good way to get a pattern started. Then mirror. Oh, hang on, let's go all the way back. Ah, that's literally the mirror down there. You can change where the mirror is, and no matter what you do, it reflects it on the other side. I love that. That's such a cool tool. So I guess now I'm gonna sit and have a proper play around with this. I'm very excited about it. Like I said, let me know if you'd like me to draw something in particular. Maybe I could do like a little draw with me, and we can like fully explore it rather than me just like throwing random shapes onto my artboard. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this little chill video. Nice little introduction to Adobe Illustrator on the iPad. I'm very excited. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you soon for the next one. Bye!